I've been asked a somewhat confusing question in the sense that people are confused about genetic counseling versus genetic testing for BRCA1 and 2. It's a good question. What comes first is, in my mind, clearly, and I think everyone that I deal with nationally and internationally, what should come first is, in fact, genetic counseling. And with the genetic counseling, there's a detailed history taken of the family, both on the maternal side and the paternal side, looking not only for a history, obviously, of breast cancer, but also ovarian cancer or other things that would indicate that somebody should be tested for BRCA1 and 2. Now, depending on the location where people live, this may not always be possible, but it's clearly the preferential way to go. The cost of testing for BRCA1 and 2 is high. There are locations where genetic counselors are not available. There are certainly physicians who are well schooled in knowing when the test should be ordered, so that would be certainly a second line approach. There may be a few other circumstances where you would go straight to actually drawing blood and doing the genetic test. So, in summary, then, it is absolutely always appropriate, always better to do the genetic counseling first. And frankly, if you don't, how do I put this? If you don't qualify, at least in the United States, for having blood drawn for BRCA1 and 2, you would have a better idea of what your real risk factors are. So my bottom line suggestion, I like to give bottom lines, is please see a genetic counselor first when it comes to this issue. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.